This week also on Real Reviews, our next film up is The Kitchen. And The Kitchen, of course, is a British sci-fi drama directed by Kibwe Tavares and the directorial debut of Daniel Kaluuya. The film stars Kane Robinson, for many people who remember from Top Boy, Jedediah Bannerman, Hope Ikpoku, Tiaje Caves, my God, I apologize if I'm butchering these names, Demi Lapido, Cristal, and Back Row G. And the film, of course, centers on the story in dystopian future London, where all social housing has been eliminated. Izi, played by Kane Robinson, and Benji, Jedediah Bannerman, fight to navigate the world as residents of the kitchen, a community that refuses to abandon their home.
Good morning. This is the Lord Kitchen, live and direct.
I could feel it, I won't come down.
I'm getting out of this place.
It's our home.
I could see it with all
eyes. Shit gets real. Saving myself.
So where do you live?
Kitchen.
It's really like what it tastes like.
Yeah.
You can say it by yourself.
What's your name? You ain't built like them.
I haven't got anywhere else to go.
What's he to you?
Friend of mine.
Some friend.
You gotta go.
What's happening?
You need to know what it's like, right?
This is war.
Wish my dad prepared him.
My mom, she said, he never loved her. But he would have loved me.
So this film is very interesting because, of course, going in, Kane Robinson, I've been watching this guy for several years as Top Boy. But in addition to him being an actor, he's probably a very well-known British rapper. And I must admit that I've never heard any of his stuff. But I know as an actor that he has lots of presence. Loved him on that show, and I was eager to see him, how he would transition to this role. Of course, the story, as I talked about, is a dystopian London. And normally when we hear that phrase in films, when we hear dystopian, it's always something gloomy. You know, the future is always dim. You've seen so many films that have kind of portrayed the future in this way. This film is a little different, right? In this dystopian future, this is like regular London, but this is probably regular London about maybe 10 years into the future, where there is some technological advances, but for the most part, the people in this film live as we live today, right? The difference, as we talked about, is that London now is pretty much the haves and the have-nots. So all of the elites or the people who are well off, the haves, are all living in like beautiful parts of London. And all of the lower class are now piled into this area that they refer to as the kitchen. Now, in addition to them being piled into this area, you know, you've got to put up with every day that the police come through, they're raiding and they're snatching these people and they're taking them. And the film never really tells you where they're taking them, whether they're arresting them, whether they're killing them. We don't know what the police are doing with these people, but there is a real strong fear factor that every time you know, the residents, when they see the police coming, they'll hang out the windows of this this project or apartment complex, and they're banging pots together to try to alert people to run, hide, get to safety, right? Now, of course, Izzy, which is played by Kane Robinson, is a resident of the kitchen. There's a kind of a British senior love daddy-esque radio announcer that's known as Lord Kitchener, who gets on the radio every morning and, you know, kind of wakes everybody up, gives them the news, lets them know what's happening in the community. And he works pretty much at a funeral parlor, where now in the future, instead of taking bodies and putting them in coffins or cremating them and burying them, they kind of put them into some sort of a device that turns them into a plant. And their loved ones can either take the plants or leave the plants there and come and visit them. You know, it's an existence where he, much like, mirrors the character that he played in Top Boy, doesn't really smile, is very stern and serious. One day at work, he oversees a funeral for a young woman who has died. Her son, who is now orphaned because both his parents are gone, notices Izzy looking at his parents or his mother, and kind of the two make a connection. And Izzy takes him home with him and kind of like cares for him and makes sure that he stays out of trouble and he's on the straight and narrow. And at the same time that's happening, the kid now, who's an orphan, has a bike. He encounters some folks who are not so nice, but they respect his heart and how he stands up. And Hope Ikapu, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing his name correctly, plays that character who kind of represents like the yin and yang of the two people who are pouring into this young kid. So the issue I had with this film is that, you know, I've used this analogy a lot when I review that, you know, we always talk about a three-act structure, and, you know, you've got your beginning, your middle, and your end. You also, I always love to use the analogy of a plane, right? Like sometimes you've heard me use the analogy that the film never takes off, right? It feels like it's 90 minutes of you taxiing cinematically around an airport, and you're waiting for this film to take off and soar and take you somewhere. And The Kitchen, to me, just feels like it never does, right? You watch the story. There's a brief flicker that there is some hope. Ultimately, by the time you get to your third act, you got nothing. The film just sort of sits there. Not a lot of hope. It's a story, I think, that I'm not even going to say it's well told. I think it's a story that is pretty much the sum of its parts, right? It's an idea that Daniel Kaluuya hatched in a barbershop, believe it or not, about 10 years earlier, where he heard stories of kids that were getting paid big money to commit robberies in a small amount of time, which was the genesis of him creating this story. I don't know. I'm not trashing the film, but I'm not saying that it's bad. I'm just saying that there was so much potential to do something, not necessarily even extraordinary, something a lot better with the story than what the story ends up. The story, as I said earlier, it just never takes off. The Kitchen, if I had to give it a grade, either a C or a C+. I think it's a showcase for Kane Robinson, who shows a little more emotion than what we've accustomed to seeing him in Top Boy. Daniel Kaluuya, who is a fantastic actor. His ability to step behind the camera with his director co-partner, I think is a step in the right direction. I'm interested to see the evolution of what Daniel Kaluuya can bring to some of these stories. But yeah, C or C+ for The Kitchen. Of course, it's going to debut on Netflix this weekend, January the 19th. Again, as I tell you every time when we do these reviews, you, of course, be the judge. I'm Tim Gordon, and until next time, we'll see you on the other side. Take care.